Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. I am your Yoshin. Sorry guys, I couldn't post my videos for last 2 or 3 weeks, I think. I was a bit busy with my studies. As you guys all know, our online classes have started. As we know, the virus is spreading very rapidly, so we should take our own precautions. Guys, please do not leave your home unless or until it is very necessary. So be safe, be healthy. Now let's get into our subject. In the previous video, we have completed the exercises on open strings. Today we are going to learn about the fret and some exercises on frets. Subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get further notifications. Now let's get into the video. Now let's see the fretboard. This is the fretboard underneath the strings. See? Underneath the strings, here is the fretboard. This fretboard includes both frets. These are the frets, the golden colored lines here underneath the strings. These are the frets, and here the gap between the frets is the fingerboard. The fretboard includes both frets and fingerboards. So only it got its name called the fretboard. It includes frets and fingerboards. The frets and fingerboards vary from guitar to guitar. In my guitar, I have 20 frets and 20 fingerboards. Now let's get into the exercises. There are 3 in total. Okay, now let's see the first exercise. In the first exercise, we are gonna use our fingers, the left hand, okay? The thumb, here some people have difficulty in catching. The thumb here should come back like this, okay? You should have a better grip here, so you do not like lose your finger. Lose the grip of your finger. So you hold it very tightly with your thumb finger, and you're gonna use your fingers of your left hand. Okay, in the first exercise, what we are gonna do is we are gonna just learn the basics. Okay, what is in the first exercise? We are gonna do like first finger on the first. These are frets, okay? We have even dots on the frets, like it represents 3rd fret, 5th fret. I'll tell you about that frets in the next video. I'll explain it to you clearly. That is about some chromatic notes. I'll teach you in the next video. Now let's see the exercise. In the first exercise, first we should place our first finger. We only use 4 fingers, not the 5th finger. We use the 5th finger to hold 4 fingers. First, we should hold the first finger you should use and hold the first fret and play. And then the second, use the second finger and play, hold the second fret, and you leave the first fret, okay? And then same, the 3rd fret. And again we use the little finger, the pinky finger, for the 4th fret. You practice it, make sure you do not get an muted sound, like not like this. You should not get the sound like this. You hold the string as hard as possible so you get the correct tune of the sound, like this. Then 2, you can call this as 1st fret, 2nd fret, 3rd fret and 4th fret. So 1, we use 1st finger for the 1st fret. 1, 2, when you are holding the 2nd fret, you should leave the 1st fret and from the 1st finger, like finger, catch it like this, because you feel comfortable when you leave this 2nd finger, 2nd fret, 3rd finger, 3rd fret, 4th finger, 4th fret. And that only you continue with all the strings. Once you are done with all the strings, like you can play it backward, like 4, 3, 2, 1. Like that, you can do it to all the strings, okay? Now let's just play it and see. First fret, first finger, 1, 2, 3, 4. And next string, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Like that we do with all the strings. And backward, you start with the 6th string, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay? The first exercise is done. Even we practice backwards, okay? I told you, right? You can't get the sound like muted sound like this. You won't get. You should hold the fret as hard as possible so you get this sound, okay? The second exercise. In this exercise, we use the same 4 fingers and we just change the pattern. We use only 4 frets in the beginning. After you practice all these things, you can go even down like. You can practice it in any fret, okay? Just the sound differs, the pitch differs. Now let's see the second exercise. In the second exercise, what happens is we just change the pattern. We use the same 4 frets, same 4 fingers, and we just change the pattern. The pattern comes like first finger, first fret. Then we skip the second fret. And we use the 3rd finger and 3rd fret. And then come back to second string and 2nd finger. You use the 2nd finger. And then again the 3rd fret. Okay, now let's see the exercise again. There is more patterns in the same second exercise. I'm teaching you just the first for now. I will teach you again. Let's just practice this one first as well as possible. The same, you should hold this as hard as possible so you get a nice tune of the, you get a nice sound like this you get. Okay, now let's see that. First finger, first fret, 1, 3, 2, and 3. Okay. Now let's see the second pattern. In the second pattern, it is just opposite. We replace the 3 we used in the first pattern, which we just learned now. We use 1, 3, 2, and then again 3. In this pattern, what we are gonna do is we are gonna use 2 instead of 3. We'll see that. See, first same. We use here 2. 1, 2, 3, and again back to 2. Okay, we replace the 3 with 2. I'll show you again. 1, 2, 3, and again 2. Now let's see the 3rd pattern. In the 3rd pattern, we use the same as the first exercise. See, we use the 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, same. I'll show you completely. This is one pattern, but I taught you by like just separating it. Okay, you give a rest between each and every pattern. Okay, now let's see that pattern totally. Yes, one second. And again, same as the first exercise. Now let's see the second exercise again and show it clearly. You can practice this on any string, okay? But first is bit easy, first string. Be careful in the cut your fingers, right? Because the first 3 strings are a bit sharp. Yeah, be careful.
the second exercise is done. You can perform this on any string or any fret. You can even come here and do it. That's the same, the sound because that's it. Okay? You can perform this on any string, any fret.
Now let's see the third exercise. In the third exercise, what we are going to do is, first we are going to use the double picking, okay? In the previous video, not the previous video, in the third or second video, I have told you, right, about the alternate picking, double picking. That double picking we are going to use here. What we are going to do, we are going to play the first fret two times, that is double picking, right? You can even use the alternate picking, but play two times. First fret, and then the second fret, two times. We should give 1 second rest, and the third fret, two times. And again play the second fret, two times. And here we will play the first exercise, but we will play each number two times, okay? Like 1, 1. Okay, let's see the exercise again. First we are gonna play the first fret two times using double picking. And again second fret, and then the third fret two times, and then the second fret two times, and then we give 1 second rest between the third we came, right? Like here we give 1 second rest, and then go to the third fret, second fret again. Now we'll give 1 second rest again, and then what we are gonna do is play the same first exercise, but we are play it two times, like first fret two times, second fret again two times, third fret two times, I mean third fret two times, fourth fret two times. That's it. The three exercises are done. Guys, you may have a doubt. We are playing here the first string fret, and which string should we play here? Please, in which string fret you are using? Take an example. You are using the first strings fret, you have to play the first string here. If you use the first string frets here and play the second string, third string or any string here, you won't have any difference between the sound. See, you should use the if you are playing here the first, using the first strings frets, you should play here the first string. You will have the difference like this. That only if you play with the second string and use the first string fret, you'll have the same sound, okay? That's it for today's video. Meet you all in the next video. Yoshin signing off.